If you are trying to conceive, it is absolutely required that you ovulate. I am going to discuss several methods that you can use to determine if you are ovulating. Some methods to detect ovulation are more reliable than others. First, the methods you can use without the need for a doctor. Number one, are your periods regular? Generally speaking, if you are getting your period regularly, about every 28 to 30 days, you can say with a high degree of certainty that you are ovulating. Subtract 14 from the length of time from one period to the next, and that is likely the day you ovulated. So, if you have a 28-day cycle from the beginning of one period to the beginning of the next, then you probably ovulated around day 14. If it was 29 days, then you likely ovulated on day 15, and so on. Number two. Use a home ovulation predictor test. There are several different kinds of ovulation tests. The most commonly used tests and the least expensive ones are the urine tests. They measure a hormone in your urine called LH, which triggers ovulation. Start checking your urine each morning before you think you will ovulate, and keep checking until it turns positive. It is a very accurate and highly reliable way to determine ovulation. There are tests that use saliva, but they can be trickier to interpret. More recently, there has been an explosion of high-tech monitors that you can put in your bed, wrap around your wrist, place in your bra, or even in your vagina. These high-tech devices measure a variety of things, such as temperature, heart rate, electrical resistance in your skin. It's tough to determine how well these instruments work, since the only evaluation of their effectiveness comes from the company selling them. They are, however, very expensive, and there isn't any data yet to say they work better than cheaper methods. Number three, a thermometer. Some of the high-tech devices measure changes in body temperature. Another way to do this is with a special thermometer called a basal temperature thermometer. It is very inexpensive, but can be tricky since there are many things that can cause your temperature to fluctuate. It is only accurate in telling you if ovulation happened after the fact. So it's good for documenting ovulation, but poor for trying to predict ovulation beforehand. Now, methods that do require a doctor. Number one, follicle monitoring. When an egg matures before ovulation, it does so inside of a small cyst called a follicle. Doctors can use ultrasound to measure how big a follicle is getting. At the same time, she can do blood tests to check your estrogen and LH levels to predict when you are going to ovulate. Number two, progesterone blood tests. After you ovulate, the levels of another hormone called progesterone will increase. A blood test in the doctor's office can look at the level of progesterone and tell you if ovulation occurred. In most laboratories, a progesterone level over 2.5 or 3 indicates ovulation. Like temperature changes, progesterone only increases after ovulation. So it's good for documenting if ovulation occurred, but not for predicting ovulation. Documenting ovulation isn't the only thing you should be doing to investigate infertility. Make sure you are performing all of the testing in this playlist, but remember to like this video first. If you have a question, leave it in the comments. Click the link in the description if you want to become a new patient. Or just subscribe to Infertility TV now. You'll get new episodes weekly. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.